السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. فأعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة، لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. Dear brothers and sisters, during the second Khalifa, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu's period, a case was presented in his court of a person whom he did not know. So he asked the people in his court if anyone knew this man. And one of the men stood up and said, "Yes, I know him." Then the Khalifa asked the man who stood up, "Do you know him? Ata'arifu hadha ar-rajul?" And the man replied, "Yes." The Khalifa then asked him three questions. The first question he asked, "Hal anta jarahu alladhi ta'arifu madkhalahu wa makhrajahu?" Have you ever been this man's neighbor? The second question he asked, "Hal sahibtahu fi safari alladhi ta'arifu bihi makarim al-akhlaq?" Have you ever traveled with him? And third question was, "Hal amaltahu bid-dinari wad-dirhami alladhi ta'arifu bihi war'a ar-rajul?" Have you ever done any financial dealings with him? The man replied no to all three questions. Umar radiallahu ta'ala became angry at him. And then he told him, "La'allaka ra'aytahu yusalli wa yarka wa yasjud fil masjid." Maybe you have seen this man praying in the masjid, doing sajda and ruku. And this is why you are saying that he is a good man. The man said, "Yes." And then Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala said to him, "You don't know this man. Your testimony is not valid, and you can go now." This is the best criteria, my dear brothers and sisters, set by Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu to know if someone is a good person or not. To judge a person's piety and iman, you need to either be their neighbor or have traveled with them or had financial dealings with them. Keeping this incident in mind, we move forward. My dear brothers and sisters, a famous French philosopher, Voltaire, once presented a rule stating that no one is a hero to his valet. That means that no one can be a hero to the people close to him. Why? Because alongside seeing the person's good attributes, they also become aware of his bad habits and actions. A person can present himself as a good man in front of the outside people, but he cannot hide his flaws in front of those who are close to him. However, Soren Simit, another philosopher, challenged this rule for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as it did not apply to him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is because whoever came near to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he immediately became a fan of his. This is due to his supreme good nature and great character. Here, I will present some examples. My dear brothers and sisters, you know, Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, the richest, most famous and respected woman, chose the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to look after her business. And she sent him with her servant Maisara to different countries. Very quickly, she came to know that her business had made a lot of profit in a short amount of time. And her servant informed her the reason. He told her that the excellent character and honesty of the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the main reason behind the success. And you know, due to the Prophet's honesty and good character, a millionaire businesswoman, Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, proposed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam herself, despite the fact that he was poor, and soon she became his wife. Here I will present another example before his prophethood. Hadrat Zaid bin Haritha, when he was 8 years old, he was kidnapped on the way home and later sold in the Ukkas market. Hakim bin Hizam, the nephew of Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, bought and later gifted him to his auntie Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha then gave Zaid to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a servant. A few years later, Zaid was 15 years old. Zaid's family came to know of his whereabouts. So his father and uncle came to rescue him. When they arrived in Makkah and met the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they told him to take whatever sum of money he wanted and return the son to them. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam refused to take any money and said to them that if Zaid wished to go with you, then he is free to go with you. Then they met Zaid, who recognized his father and uncle, but refused to go with them. His father was shocked and told him that أَتَخْتَارُ الْعُبُودِيَّةَ عَلَى الْحُرِّيَّةِ وَعَلَىٰ أَبِيكَ وَأَمِّكَ يَا زَيْد. You prefer being a slave rather than being free, and you prefer to live with strangers instead of your father and uncle. Then Zaid radiallahu ta'ala anhu replied, what goodness I saw in this man, I will never find anywhere else. And he decided to stay with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, وَمَا أَخْتَارُ عَلَيْكَ أَحَدًا قَدُّ وَاللَّهِ أَنْتَ بِمَنْزِلَةِ الْأَبِي وَالْعَمِّ. I will not choose anyone but you, for you are a father and an uncle to me. Zaid's father and uncle returned back home, leaving their son. Zaid had personally seen the Prophet's good character, and hence was not ready to leave his company and at any expense. My dear brothers and sisters, when the first revelation came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he became very frightened and returned to his home trembling with fear. He told his wife Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, Zammiluni, Zammiluni, cover me, cover me. And she did so until he became calm again. Once he restored his security, he informed Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha of the incident that had just occurred in the cave of Hira and said that he was scared. Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha then tried to comfort him by describing his good character and said, Kalla wallahi la yukhzika Allah innaka latasilu rahma wa tahmilu al-kalla wa takhri al-zayfa wa tu'inu ala nawaibi al-dahar. Allah will never disgrace you. You unite uterine relations. You bear the burden of the weak. You help the poor and the needy. And you entertain the guests and endure hardship in the path of truthfulness. Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha spent, 15 years with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as his wife before his prophethood. And she was fully aware of his good character, which is why she supported him with full confidence. When the revelation came and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam made prophet, The people who were very close to him all embraced Islam without any question and hesitation, including Khadija, Zaid, Abu Bakr, and Ali, and others. Raziyallahu ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. My dear brothers and sisters, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha narrated, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was taken on his night journey to Bayt al-Maqaddis, al-Masjid al-Aqsa, people started to talk about that. Some people who had believed in him apostatized. Some men went to Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu and said, do you want to know what your companion is saying? He is claiming that he was taken last night to Bayt al-Maqdis. He asked, did he say that? They replied, yes. He then said, if he said that, it is true. If the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that, then it is true. They inquired, do you truly believe that last night he went to Bayt al-Maqdis and came back before morning? He answered, yes, I believe him with regard to something more unlikely than that. I believe him with regard to the revelation that comes to him from the heavens in the morning or in the evening. For this reason, my dear brothers and sisters, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was called as As-Siddiq. This hadith recorded by Imam Hakim with a sound chain of narration. My dear brothers and sisters, according to Sahih al-Bukhari, Ghawras ibn al-Haris, from the tribe of Ghadfan, announced to his tribe that he will kill the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said to his tribe, Allah aqtul Muhammadan. He then set off to find the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and found him resting beneath a tree with his sword hanging from the tree. He took the sword and was approaching the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam awoke. Ghawras then asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Man yamna'uka minni?" Who will save you from me now? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied calmly, "Allah, Allah, and Allah." And Ghawras dropped the sword, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam took sword and asked Ghawras, "May yamna'uka minni?" Now, who will save you from me now? Ghawras became frightened, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't do anything to him. Instead, he told him to go back to his tribe. When Ghawras returned to his tribe, what he said? This is the point I want to raise here. He came to kill the Prophet, but when he returned to his tribe, he said, what he said? He said, "Ji'tukum min indi khairin nas." I am coming to you from the best of people. And he narrates the whole story of his people. The people of his tribe were very impressed by him and by his religion. My dear brothers and sisters, Sumama bin Assal, king of Yamama, was a big enemy of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all the Muslims. He had already killed many Muslims. Once during a journey, the companions of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam captured him and brought him to the Prophet's mosque and tied him to the pillar of the mosque. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam found out, he came to Sumama and said, "Mada indaka ya Sumama?" Fakala indi ya Muhammad khair. What do you have to say yourself, O Sumama? Sumama said, "I have a good, O Muhammad." Then he mentioned three things. First of all, he said, "In taqtul taqtul da damin." If you kill me, it will be a revenge because I too have killed many of your companions. Second thing he said, وَإِن تُنْعِمْ عَلَى شَاكِرٍ. If you have mercy on me and free me, then I shall grateful to you for this favor. The third thing he said, وَإِن كُنْتَ تُرِيدَ الْمَالِ فَسَلْ تُوْتَ مِنْهُ مَا شِيْتَ. If you want money in compensation, I shall give you whatever amount you ask. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam leaves him and returns the next day. The same question and answers are repeated over that 3 days. On the third day, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam suddenly ordered the companions to free Sumama. Let him go. Who then goes to the nearest palm grove, the dates, garden trees, on the outskirts of Medina, near the Al-Baqi, and has a bath. Then he returned back and made his way to the Prophet's masjid. There, he stood before a congregation of Muslims and said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his servant and his messenger. He then went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said 3 things. Wallahi ya Muhammad, ma kana ala al-ardi wajhun abghadha ilayya min wajhika, faqad asbaha wajhuka ahabba al-wujuhi kulliha ilayya. O Muhammad, by God, there was never on this earth a face more hateful than yours. But now, yours is the dearest face of all to me. Second thing he said, Wallahi ma kana min deenin abghadha ilayya min deenika, fa asbaha deenuka ahabba deeni kullihi ilayya. Up until today, the religion I hated the most was Islam. But today, the most beloved religion to me is Islam. The third thing he said, Wallahi ma kana min baladin abghadha ilayya min baladik, fa asbaha baladuka ahabba al-biladi kulliha ilayya. Up until today, the city I hated the most was Medina. But now, the most beloved city to me is Medina. My dear brothers and sisters, look, whoever came near to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam immediately became his admirer and devotee. And many of them embraced Islam. Why? Because of his seerah and character. This is the point we need to catch from today's khutbah. If you want to support Islam, we have to practice. We have to copy our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I have given you only a few examples, but there are many, many more incidents which prove this. The message of today's khutbah, my dear brothers and sisters, is that if we believe in Islam and claim that we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we should prove it through our actions, and not only by saying things. We should demonstrate all the qualities the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam possessed, so that the people around us, especially non-Muslims, can see the true nature of a good Muslim and thus become closer to Islam. This is today's need and most important duty upon us. I pray to Allah Almighty to give us tawfiq to practice Islam and to present a good and true image of Islam to those around us. Ameen. Aqulu qawli haza wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum li sa'iril muslimin fastaghfiru innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. Innal hamdalillah نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له
ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وصلي على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى الملائكة المقربين وعلى الخلفاء الراشدين وعلى الصحابة كلهم أجمعين وعلى من تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم انصرهم على عدوك وعدوهم اللهم اجعلنا من نصر دين محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم عباد الله أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله رحمني ورحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وجل وأتم وأهم وأكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء نحوا سنقربك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا
وزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى.
الله.